Let's talk about the name, the Washington football team.
Yeah.
Come on, that's weird, right?
I don't think it's that weird, but it's definitely a mixed views on this. But I think the thinking prior was, hey, we need to get something that can be a great placeholder. But there's also precedent for a team that is named after the place it's in.
Did you consider the Redskin name racist, like when there was a big debate going?
I come from this bubble that definitely had that mindset. Oh, this is obviously a derogatory term. I had the analogies in my head of what it would be for me as a black person. You know, like I had all that stuff, and that was the broad narrative. As I jumped into this role, I found out that the debate of folks closer to it was much more nuanced than that. I think everybody can agree the right thing is to move forward into a new name, brand, and identity that captures the best parts of our history and allows us to innovate and move into the future.
You were a player, now you're a president. Is there systemic racism in the NFL?
I see systemic racism, systemic gender bias, systemic bias of all sorts as just a bit of the air we breathe in society. So it's a little bit of, does it exist? Period, yes. Therefore, it exists everywhere.
Is it more profound?
I think it is more obvious because 70% of the men on the field are black men, right? So I think it just, the optics of it are different.
In your role as president of the Washington football team, do you still feel like you're experiencing racism in the capacity of running the team?
I think the way that I've experienced racial bias, which is my preferred term, is something that I've experienced ever since sort of, actually through high school, college, and definitely in my professional career. And it's that when you have any moment of accomplishment, accolade, appointment, or whatever it is, the first question in people's minds is this tokenism? Is this a PR stunt? Do they deserve it? And that is an additional burden that sits on people of color, women, LGBTQ plus people, that doesn't exist on other folks. It always pops up, no matter what the track record was before. And as a result, you carry that with you. It's something that every black professional experiences at some level.